Oi, namaste, como vocês estão? Dosto, Mera na Bichina Reme, Brasil. Welcome to my channel, full of love. And as I said, I'm from Brazil. And if you don't know me, welcome. I write to Hindustan because I've been in India and I felt some connection with it. So my channel is just to keep connecting with you, India and Brazil. This is amazing. So I've reacted to Enjoy and Jamie like a few weeks ago, and I truly love this song. It's very sentimental, very culture, and like super well done. So like it's amazing. It's just amazing. So I got this video of Nutshell, the channel Nutshell, where he explains the story behind it, why this video is so important, why this video got so many views. So once I really love this video, I want to know more about it. So I think you want to too. So 1, 2, 3, and go.
Just 20 days after its release, this song has 80 million views on YouTube.
80 million.
80 million. From reaction videos to trendy reels, this foot tapping number is everywhere. While we've all been grooving to Enjoy and Jamie by D and Aruva, it has layers of meaning that you may not know about. So, let's just tell you what these are.
A lot of people
first of
told
all,
me
can we
about
take a
these
moment
layers.
to appreciate the casting? I mean, just when do we see so many dark-skinned, gorgeous people on screen together? Certainly not in our Bollywood item numbers. Now, for me, the magic of this monster hit lies in two things. Let's begin with the more obvious one. Take the beginning itself. The first few seconds of the track start with people playing this flat drum called parai.
Parai.
Parai has been known as an instrument played only by the marginalized group Dalits, and that too at death ceremonies. Now, to see this instrument right at the start of such a popular hit is very powerful, isn't it? It's how the artists are reclaiming what society has shunned and then making it popular again. Move 10 seconds forward. Here, along with the strong parai beats, you hear this sound. This loud, high-pitched, rhythmic sound is called ululation or kolava in Tamil. It's a sound made by women in ceremonies across India, and it's a sound that depicts a mix of celebration and lament, of sorrow and joy. This mix is the most prominent at this particular line that comes right in the middle of the song. I don't think there's ever been
That's
a line
so good.
That talks about generational oppression better than this. It's exactly at this moment where we all went, whoa, this song is deep. And that is precisely the effect that the writer Aruva wanted. Here he used an ancient form of music called opara. Opara is a kind of sad music that historically people from lower caste communities perform at funerals. To me, opara is the actual hip-hop of India. It's the resistance art form of the country, said Aruva, for whom opara is a rebellion against the system of caste oppression. And that's the beauty of this song. It is channelizing anger against long-drawn oppression, but doing
That's
it in a way
amazing.
that instantly makes our feet tap. Just take the word anjami. It's a word that mothers use in Tamil to lovingly refer to their children. But this same word also has a violent history. It was used to refer to lords and masters. And in the song, the artists are reclaiming even the movements. We see Aruva beating his chest so many times, and that is a gesture we usually associate with loss or mourning. But to see it in this context tells us that the song comes with a strong message and is not just an entertaining dance number. Now for me, the magic of Enjoy and Jamie lies in just two shots in particular. One is when we see Dee's hand reaching and grabbing the soil. And the second comes
That's
in
amazing.
A later scene when that same hand reaches out to an elder working in the field. In these two shots lie the hidden messages of this song. One is that of the importance of nature, the many animals, flowers, and types of land becoming characters in the song. Humans are not the central character in this narrative. They exist alongside nature. And the song makes us feel the importance of this nature, makes us close to this nature, tells us to preserve this nature. Not just that,
amazing.
The song also talks about the struggles of the people who are closest to this nature. Right from the outset, it pays homage to the landless peasants tilling a land they have never owned. For they are the ones toiling the hardest but reaping the least, all because of our over-exploitation. And yet, we don't see these laborers as sad. They're dancing, enjoying, and their smile is a subtle slap in the face to the media that always portrayed them as sad victims.
They know what
them
the
dancing
truly
together
happiness
is a visual representation
is.
Of the message that runs throughout the
That's
song.
My opinion.
That of coming together, that of communal values. In a way, this song is about the struggles of Ariva's grandmother, Valiyamma, who was herself a landless laborer. We see her in the lyrics as well as the visuals. In fact, the song begins with the word Odia, which is something a grandmother would use to call out to her grandchildren. And of course, there's that extremely strong end visual, where we see Ariva's grandmother right in the center, sitting on a throne. Now, did you notice that this throne is different from the fantasy gold throne that Dee had been sitting on in the earlier frames? This one is made from the same weaving technique that was shown as being practiced by the community, again giving us the message of communal value. Showing us that this is a song about unity and celebration, but a celebration that comes from understanding the pain of the oppressed. So Enjoy Anjami is a great example of art that can sensitize and unify people. It has given us one of those rare moments when we truly appreciate a song that is not part of some hit blockbuster. And we can only hope that there are many, many more such songs to come. If you like this
I
video,
hope so.
Then tell us.
If you like this video, okay, so first of all, thank you to this guy that made this video explaining everything. As I said, I was already in love to this song. I felt this history, this message, these emotions just watching the video. But of course, I didn't know about Tamil and all these small things that the video represents. So, for example, the castes and community values and like the power and the oppressor and poor and rich. So this video shows how community, nature and equality, it's so important. So like the video is perfect, the song is amazing and the message behind it, it's perfect. So like there is no reason to not like the song, like there is no reason, it's just perfect. So congratulations Enjoy Anjami and all the people who was making this video. I am just super impressed and I just want to say thank you, because we need more messages like this, not just in India but in Brazil and the entire world. We have to be together and be aware to the nature and equality and everything. So thank you very much for watching my videos. I have Instagram, so you can talk to me there. I have a Patreon, so if you want to some exclusive content, and I hope you like my video. If you like my video, please subscribe and let me know what you want me to react. So see you next video. Take care. Namaste. Namaskar.